Mes que tal, soy Sierra Lafay, bienvenue hao. So this video is actually going to be an update with my experience on pantothenic acid. I'll have my part one linked up here. If you want more details about everything that I was doing with taking the vitamins, make sure that you check out that video first and then watch this one, because I have learned some differences now that I have taken into consideration. So you may find that some of the things that I was doing in that first video may help you better than some of the things that I found work better for me now that I am gotten on the vitamin. Or, I mean, you could just see the parallel for yourself and you may notice, hey, I was doing that, what you said initially, and maybe I should try doing your updated, what you're doing now that you're on pantothenic acid. I'm going to stop rambling because I just feel like I'm talking. Y bueno, nada más decir.
Real quick, I forgot to mention in my intro that I did not put on any makeup other than some concealer under my eyes and then some mascara. And I'm looking at my footage like, man, I should have put on some makeup because I am so embarrassed about my skin. But I personally don't like watching acne videos where the person's wearing makeup, because I feel like it's harder to see someone's skin condition and maybe how bad or how not bad it is in comparison to yours, because that's usually what I do when I watch acne videos, is that I try to find people who have similar acne to me and then see what's working for them, and then I'll do or try some of the things that are working for them. You'll probably look at my clip and say, Sierra, your skin isn't even that bad, but my skin was a whole lot worse and I was actually diagnosed with severe acne. So it's not severe as some people, but it's definitely more severe than the average person. So I went ahead and just let myself be pretty much barefaced to show people that, hey, I have really bad acne too. Check with your doctor to see if this is something you could potentially take.
So, although I haven't been on this vitamin for that long, my skin has really been like this on it. Partially, it's my fault. I wanna say, shortly after I filmed my first video telling you guys about the vitamin, I ended up losing my bottle, and then I ended up going to New York. So I was off the vitamin for like a week and a half, and I was going to order some more, but I was like, no, I'm determined to find these vitamins, but I never could find it. So that's why I ended up being off of it so long. That messed me up because I ended up breaking out quite a bit once I stopped taking it. I was still taking my cod liver oil, my zinc, my probiotic, and vitamin C, and my multivitamin, but I wasn't taking the pantothenic acid. So I definitely noticed that my skin was not ready to not have that vitamin, which I don't want to be stuck on a vitamin where my body depends on it. So hopefully after another month or two, I can begin to wean myself off of it. But because I had just started taking it, really, there wasn't the time for me to just like not take it for a week and a half. So anyway, finally ordered some more vitamins, got them. Then slowly my skin started to heal again. And then it was about a week and a half before my cycle, and my body didn't care nothing about no pantothenic acid. I broke out like I usually do, but probably even a little bit worse, with cystic acne and just like a lot of small little pimples. So that was very frustrating. Like, I really was devastated over that, because I was like, man, nothing's working. Even these vitamins, I thought they were working. But then after I realized that my cycle came, like, it was related to my cycle. So I did learn that you should take a vitamin called DIM about a week and a half to 2 weeks before your period, because that's going to help with your breakouts, so minimize your breakouts. So I definitely ordered some. I'll have everything that I'm using down below. So I've ordered the vitamins probably 4 times now. The first 2 times I was using this brand, and now I had just decided, let me just switch it up to see if I notice a difference. So I tried the Nutricost brand. I just decided to try this brand just to see if there was a difference, and honestly, guys, I noticed a difference between this brand and the initial brand that I was using. And it may also just be because I've been on the vitamin a little bit longer, so I'm noticing my results getting better and better each week. But right now I'm going to stick to this brand. I also recently, within the past week actually, have upped my dosage from 15 pills to 20 pills. And I used to take them, when I was taking them before, I would do 5 in the morning, 5 in the afternoon, and 5 for dinner. That wasn't working for me because I don't eat 3 meals a day. So I was forcing myself to eat 3 meals a day, and that was really, really hard for me. So I remember one time I was like, oh shoot, I forgot to take my vitamins. So I ended up taking like 10 at one time, and then I took 5 at a later time. And when I woke up the next morning, I found there was a little bit of a difference in my skin clear up. So I was like, I tried it again, and I was noticing a difference. So I said, I'm just gonna start taking it more in chunks. And then once I decided to do 20 vitamins a day, I decided, well, let me do 10 and 10. And I don't know why, but I just feel like taking it for me in those segments with a meal just works a little bit better. But you have to do what works for you if you decide to get on these vitamins. Quick disclaimer, I am not telling anyone to go and buy any of these vitamins. Make sure you consult your medical professional before doing any of this. So yeah, I'm still on the pantothenic acid, and this week has actually been the best results that I've had yet. When I first started taking pantothenic acid, my skin was definitely clearing up very quickly, but I also found that I was still getting daily breakouts, and then it would still be once in a while. And when I say once in a while, like once every 3 days, I would still get like cystic acne here and there. It was just when my period came, it went crazy.
So I did go through a bit of a purging stage with my skin. 2 or 3 weeks ago, it started purging, which is where I kept feeling little pimples under my skin, but they would never really go away. And then finally, those little pimples came to the surface of my skin. So I had like a little bit of a breakout, but it was my skin just trying to clean itself out, which was pretty great. So yeah, when I say my skin was going up and down like this with the vitamins, that's what I meant. Like one day I would be fine, and then the next day I would purge, then the next day I'd be breaking out because of my cycle, and then the next day I would still be breaking out, but not as much. So finally I've been doing pretty good with not breaking out.
I definitely have a lot of dark marks because I pick and play with my pimples, just because I'd rather touch a smooth surface when I have to wash my face. Yeah, so right now I have my skin out and you can see all the dark marks that I have. And I'm gonna also insert some pictures of the difference my skin has been once I started taking it and then how it is now.
So this side is actually my problematic side of my face. The other side of my face breaks out, but not this bad. You can see some cystic acne going on in there, and then you can see some dark marks. What you guys can't really see is that I have a lot of little pimples in there. I can definitely feel them. I can see them in the sunlight, but in natural lighting, you don't really see much. So you can see with this picture, my cystic acne has completely gone down. I probably have 1 or 2 bumps there. My dark marks have lightened, and most of my small acne is pretty much gone. When I feel my face, I still feel some bumps here or there, but not nearly as much as I did compared to that first image.
I have changed my facial wash. I now use the Cetaphil cleansing foaming wash. At first I was kind of like, I'm not sure about this, but now that my face has gotten used to it, I really love it. I think foam cleansers for me work the best. And then as far as the facial lotion, I'm still loving my Dr. Dennis Ross one. That's like a moisture cushion. That stuff is amazing. It smells good. Oh, I no longer take probiotics because I can't afford to keep buying all these vitamins, especially now I'm taking 20 of these a day. I go through this like so quickly. On the cod liver oil, the zinc, now that I have DIM, I'm not gonna do the probiotics, even though I do need a probiotic. Still on my multivitamin, and I'm still on vitamin C. So I also don't want to just keep adding vitamins, because I really don't know how healthy that is. But I do still try to watch what I eat. I know it's when I eat dairy, my skin hates it, so I only indulge in that maybe like, I only try to indulge in it. I tell myself to only indulge in it once a month, but the reality of it is I probably indulge in it maybe once a week. And it's Cold Stone ice cream. If anybody knows about Cold Stone ice cream, you can relate. That stuff is addictive. My favorite flavor is the founder's favorite, and I have an extra bowl sitting for me downstairs that I'm trying not to eat until tomorrow when 90 Day Fiance comes on, because I love that show. But part of me is like, I want to eat it tonight. But anyway, I highly recommend this. Definitely talk to your doctor about it. Do research about it. This stuff has seriously helped to change my life. And I'm really hopeful that in the next 2 months, I won't have any acne whatsoever. I'll just have these dark marks to try to get rid of, which I can do. I don't mind the dark marks, especially because I can hide it with makeup. But you can't hide bumps and cystic acne with makeup. Like, you're gonna see right through it. And then you kind of feel like, I don't want to say, I'll say me, I feel stupid trying to wear makeup, heavy makeup on top of bumpy skin. It doesn't look pretty on me. So, but yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I really appreciate you guys allowing me to be vulnerable, sharing my insecurities and my acne journey with you guys. If you struggle with acne and have been finding things that work for you, leave them in the comment section below. I would love to check them out and maybe even do some research for myself. Y bueno, nada más se dice.
I want to thank me for doing all this hard work.